So is this PowerPoint is visible to you? I think today there is some placement going on, it seems. Which company is there today? Okay, Interactive Brokers. That's why a less number of students are there. Okay, so we are taking the live topic today for the lecture as per the syllabus only, but I'm going in the sequence of the topics. We have learned about NoSQL databases. Okay, NoSQL databases are not only SQL, that is a relational database management system for distributed massive amount of data stores, and there are four types. There are four types of NoSQL databases: key store, document store, graph store, and the column based. Okay, so the key store ka example that we studied was about DynamoDB, Amazon's DynamoDB, in the last lecture. Okay, we are on the third chapter of your syllabus, that is NoSQL databases, NoSQL databases, not only SQL databases, that is a relational database management system for a distributed databases, for the distributed databases for the massive amount of data, which are stored on the clusters of computers, that is the commodity hardware. Okay, so similar to Hadoop HDFS, you have clusters of computers connected to each other, and your data is so huge that it is stored in the form of files in a distributed fashion. And the database management system for such a huge data is called as a NoSQL database. Okay, so on the top of Hadoop kind of architecture, such databases are working. And there are finally, the data is stored in the form of a flat file. Now there are four types of these NoSQL databases: key store, document store, then graph store, and column based. In the previous lecture, we have studied about NoSQL database data type key value, and the example that we have seen is Amazon's DynamoDB. And in case of Amazon's website, why this database is more suitable? Because the data is stored in the form of key value pair for Amazon DynamoDB, and there are millions of users who are accessing Amazon's website at the same time. And this session information in the form of session variables is that key value store is more relevant for that. And the session information is stored in the form of Amazon DynamoDB. Plus the user's shopping cart, the contents which are added onto the shopping cart, because user is interacting with the site for a long amount of time. And when finally he selects and finalizes his transaction or shopping items, then he selects, then he clicks on the button buy. So whenever the amount that the user has spent on the website is more in exploring the items, in searching, reading, and understanding the configurations, that time is more amount of time. And whenever the transaction is happening is a very small amount of time. So the transaction, when it is happening, that entire transaction information is stored in the RDBMS of that Amazon's website. But your session data and your data which is there into the shopping cart, that is in the form of key value pairs, and that data is stored in the form of Amazon's DynamoDB. So my previous lecture was the first type of NoSQL database, that is a key value store. We studied all the features, functionalities, and a typical example and the crude operations, like you just have to get the key, put the key, or delete the key, or perform any operation on key value. Such simple operations are there. So that was the simplest database for NoSQL databases that we studied in the last lecture. Today's lecture I'm concentrating on document store database, that is MongoDB. Okay, so the today's lectures ka learning objective are to understand MongoDB, that is a document store NoSQL database. First we will see the features of document store NoSQL database, and then we'll see the example in terms of MongoDB and one sample table for MongoDB and the crude operations for MongoDB. Okay, we as per the syllabus, we don't go into like we are not studying this subject like a database management system. The scope of this particular topic is that there is always a question of around 5 marks on a particular type of data store. Okay, so so today we are learning about this document store. I think this is visible to you, this PowerPoint slides. Okay, so the second type of NoSQL database is a document store. Now in case of document store, if you see this right hand side wala diagram, you can see that it is also a similar to, or some modification of key value pairs. It is some modification of key value pair. Like here you have the document, and the document, entire document is accessed via key. So it is a little bit modification of key value pair, because it is also using the hashing techniques. And but a key value and the column store databases, they lack in the formal structure. Okay, in case of key value, what happens is that everything is stored in the form of key value. There is no data type for key. There is no data type, fixed data type for value. Key can be anything, a string, array, or anything. Value can also be anything. And the keys are indexed. Keys are indexed, but values are not indexed. In RDBMS, values are indexed. Okay, in case of key value database, keys are indexed. But there is no proper indexing for the values here in case of key value. And and column store mein you can extract the entire column. The column families are stored in sequence, but you can all the columns are not for the particular row are not stored in the sequence. So these two databases, they lack the formal structure. There is no proper structure. Okay, key value is the simplest form of NoSQL database. Only everything is in the form of key and value. Key and value. Value can be anything, like it is a JSON object, or it can be a binary object, or it can be the audio object. So it can be anything, but there is no other schema, nothing. Only everything is stored in the form of key, and the keys are hashed to the table, and you can extract the corresponding values. And only the operations that you can perform is put key value, get key value, or delete a key value, or you can perform any operation on the key values. Okay, so it is a very simple kind of database, and there is not much functionality available, and searching within the document is not possible. You cannot perform any search operation. You just provide the key, get the value. Provide the key, get the value. Even column store mein, every column is accessed using a key. That is a row ID. So we have to study column store in detail. Like then in the next lecture we will study column store database. Okay, so I think you have understood about today's plan, that we are on the third chapter of the syllabus, that is NoSQL databases, and in the NoSQL databases we are studying the second type of NoSQL data store, that is a document store. And why document store? Because it provides some sort of additional functionality to key value, and searching is easy in this case, and some sort of relationships can be established here. There are no internal joins are defined as similar to RDBMS. RDBMS is designed in such a way that internally the architecture of RDBMS will allow you to have the foreign keys and the linking of the tables with each other and joins. So that internally that architecture of the RDBMS is very complex, and then whenever you fire the query it takes time. But here in case of this document store, we can link to documents, but that linking is not at the database architecture level, so it's not taking much time. Okay, so we'll see the data model for document store is a collection of different documents. Data model for this document store is a collection of different, means your table is a collection of different kinds of documents. One table may have multiple documents. A group of documents is your table if you compare it with the RDBMS. This particular document store is inspired by Lotus Notes. IBM has a product called as Lotus Notes for, that is a document management system of IBM, and we can perform many operations or you can share the document. They can be simultaneously updated, and lots of facilities are there about the document. And even the documents can be processed online. So this is a very advanced document management system of Lotus Notes, IBM's Lotus Notes. On the basis of this Lotus Notes, this document store is invented. Okay, so the idea is taken from Lotus Notes of IBM. In this model, data is stored inside the document. Data is stored inside the document like a similar text document. But that document has key value collection. One document may have a group of key values. Okay, are you understanding? A particular table may have multiple documents. Every document has some key value pairs. And the collection of documents is your table. So the key is used to access the value. Key, even there is a high level, like to access a document, there is a key. So every document is accessed by using a key. Okay. These documents are not typically forced to have a particular schema. There is no fixed structure for every document. Your table may contain, it is a collection of documents. So one document may be different than the other document. So there is no fixed schema. So they are flexible. Okay. Right now we are talking in general about the features of document store. So we can say that documents can contain different types of key value pairs, key array pairs, or even nested documents. Okay, so let's revise about this. Document store is a type of NoSQL database because a key value and column store, they lack a formal structure and there are no indexing, searching is very difficult for them. So document store databases allow you to have proper searching within the document for something. It is inspired by Lotus Notes of IBM. And a document store database is nothing but a collection of documents. And a document is a collection of key value pairs. So, and the keys can be anything. Value can be anything. And one document can be different from the other document. Okay. See, the document store, the database is a collection of documents. Every document is different from each other. It is flexible architecture. One document may have one particular structure, another document may have another particular structure. So some of the fields are absent in one document, some of the fields are present. So there can be this flexibility is there. So it is, we can call it as a semi-structured document. And a document may contain a collection of key values. So key values are key and corresponding value in any data type, or key and array, or even a document may contain another document. Okay, so I think you have got some idea about document store. Now, it uses tree structure. So it facilitates you the searching easily. Searching within the tree is easy. So a particular document is having a tree structure like document object model of your browser. So everything is stored in the form of a node and in the leaf node and then the so in the form of tree. So for example, employee ID is equal to 2300. Then there is an address, then there is a street. Address contains a street, building, and it is of the text type. Like this, everything is in the form of a tree structure. We can represent everything, a document, in the form of a tree. Okay, like XML document. For example, a document can be a XML document or JSON document. JSON is JavaScript object notation, data model, and key value pairs which support objects. Your value can be an object or record or structure or list or array or map or date or boolean or a string, and even a nested document. Or it can be a XML document, or it can be any other structured document. Okay, so what we are talking here is that a document is represented in the form of a tree structure, starting from the root node to the leaf nodes. All the elements can be represented in the form of a tree, and the document can be a JSON or binary script object notation, BSON, or XML, or any other structured document. And it can model some complex objects. And your value can be record, structure, list, array, map, anything. and it provides you very simple structure search APIs. And the examples of are MongoDB, Couchbase, or CouchDB. These are some of the examples of document store databases. So we are going to see about MongoDB. Okay. In the exam, they ask you about what is NoSQL data stores and explain two data stores in detail. So you can select any two data stores. If you selected a document store, then you write down these features and then explain MongoDB as a case study. Okay. Or sometimes they specify the names of the data stores that you have to explain with the help of example. So you need to prepare all four data stores thoroughly. And there's always a question for 15 marks in the exam. Now, if you compare this document store with the RDBMS table, then your table is nothing but a collection of document. The entire table, in relational model, you have a table and a table is a group of rows. So here in this case, table is a group of collection of document. Table is a collection of documents. Okay. Here you have the row. So one row is one document. In case of document store, one row is represented as a one document. Now the row may you have the columns in the table. So every column element is a key value pair. So that value is the value of that column field and key is the name of the column. Okay, so here key is the name of the column and value is the value of that particular field. And in case of here, the columns are fixed. Na? So if the columns are fixed, then only you consider about the values because you know the column names are fixed for every row. But here it is not like that. Every row ka columns are not fixed. So key column elements are stored as key and value, where key indicates the name of the column and value indicates the value of the column. Okay, so we can revise this. A column element for a particular row or particular document is a key value pair, where key indicates the name of the column, value indicates the value field, and all this group of key values will combine together into a document. Document is similar to the row of the table, and a group of documents or collection of documents is your table. Okay, and here we have joins, which are at RDBMS level internally. Once you define the relationship between the tables, the joins are provided by the model itself or the database itself. But here, such kind of join queries is not available. Okay. So now you see here, I have written down here the features which you need to remember always, like very easy interface with the common languages. For MongoDB, a very easy interface is available, like APIs are provided. And by using APIs, you can directly write a program in Java, JavaScript, PHP, Ruby, Perl, Scala, C, C++, C#. For all such languages, APIs are available. So easily you can write a Java program and your database is in the form of a MongoDB document store and you can access the data in your program. And it is using hash-based technique. It is using a hash-based technique and schemaless database. So hash-based means you are having the keys are hashed, and the partitions are decided where the particular document is stored. In reality, the key is stored as a string. Okay. So the keys are hashed to a particular partition where the collection is stored. And every document will have a ID created. Underscore ID is created for every document which will have some value. Or the value or the field name is reserved by the system. It uses binary script object notation. MongoDB uses binary script object notation. So everything is stored in the form of a binary kind of value. Okay, so these are the features which you need to remember always, that APIs are provided, you can write easily a program in using any language, hash-based techniques are used, a document can be accessed using a key, and every document has some ID generated, and the value is also system generated, and it uses BSON format, that is binary script object notation, which is based on JSON. format to store the data. And so you need to remember all these four features. These are very important, so they are so I have kept it visible always. See here in the diagram, like suppose you have the key and the relational model may you have the keys and references are created, but it is not like that. In case of document store, you have all the it is a collection of documents, collection of all these documents, and every document has a key and value pair. Okay, so you can see here in the curly bracket, the document is there and some ID it's having value, then some other key and a corresponding value, other key corresponding value. Even the value can be an array of values. So like this, it is the table is collection of things. Everything is in the form of collections, collection documents. Is your database model, okay, document model. So let's see the features. It's open source, so it is free of cost. Okay, this is the logo of MongoDB, like this black color background with a green leaf is the logo for them. That's open source. Open source, you don't have to buy this database. It's openly available. You can just download and start creating your database. It is developed by the company called as Tengen in 2007. Okay, so they came up with this document store, data store, which is very popular. Okay, and it's very flexible. So people are using MongoDB for, because today you have some requirement, tomorrow you have some other requirement, and you want to change the structure of your table and you want to add some other columns. You have 5 columns today and tomorrow you want 10 different columns. So that flexibility is provided by MongoDB, and you have the previous data items which are already stored. You don't have to change them. And you can go on adding a new data items with the new added columns. Okay, so lots of flexibility is there, and it's fast also. And you can store a huge amount of data which can be accessed easily. You just have to provide the key and get the value. Okay, so it is becoming very popular. It is developed by Tengen in 2007. The term is coined from this humongous open source. And the Mongo is taken from it, that term. It is a document-based data store, and hash-based techniques are used to store the information. All the keys are hashed by using some hashing algorithm. So you can easily retrieve the string, and you don't have to search sequentially through the database. Okay. So searching becomes very easy. Other NoSQL features are the same features are there for a document store also, that it is distributed cross-platform. Flexible data model is there. The schema is not fixed. One document may have five columns. The other document may have only 3 columns. So flexible data model and dynamic schema. Then indexing is possible. The document indexing is possible. High performance because of hashing. High availability. Always it is available 24/7. You don't have to shut down the data store to make any changes. Fault tolerant. If the machines, there are multiple copies of your data are residing at multiple locations. So if one particular partition is not available, then the other part of data can be retrieved from the other part, or it can be accessed from the other part. Automatic scaling is there. Whenever the load is increased in your application, automatically new machines can be added, or they can be used on cloud to store the data. Okay, and from the CAP theorem, it gives you the facility of consistency and partition tolerance. Consistency and partition tolerance is the highly considered for this MongoDB data store. Okay, so they morely they concentrate on partition tolerance and consistency. And this database is written in C++ language. Okay, so the creation of this database is done by this Tengen in C++ language. Okay, so what is the functionality that is provided by MongoDB is that dynamic schema is there. There is no data definition language like create table or something like that is not there. It is a document store database. Secondary indexes are also there. And the query language is via APIs. APIs are provided, so you can write a program and access the data. Atomic writes are there. and fully consistent reads are there, because it is concentrating on C part and P part of CAP theorem. So atomic writes are there, and so atomicity is there, and fully consistent reads are there. So it is designed in such a way that the system is configured in such a way that it can perform atomicity for write operations, and fully consistent read operations are there. So it gives you the facility of consistency. And master slave replication is there with automated failover. Okay, so here the replication data ka multiple copies are residing na, in case of Hadoop kind of architecture. So here for replication, master slave replication method is used to have the replicated copies. Then built-in horizontal scaling is there, where horizontally scaling is used, and you can go on adding the new machines, or the new machines will be from the existing cluster, new machines will be used in case of load, increase in the load. And the range-based partitioning of data is used. Automatic range-based partitioning is used. Means the keys are hashed, so the hash value will give you the partition where the data is to be stored, or the exact location. There are no joins and for transactions. Now, why to use MongoDB? Because we can query the database. We can search something from the data store, and the queries are very simple for big data. Okay, and this functionality can be applicable to web applications. Easy and fast integration of data is there, and it's well suited for even complex transactional systems. Okay, so this indicates what is the functionality in terms of the cluster architecture, and why to use this MongoDB, because it is similar to the normal data store, but it can handle the huge data with simple query. For websites also it can be there for in the background, and it's well suited for heavy and complex transactional systems. And for a cluster architecture, it uses master slave replication, built-in horizontal scaling, atomicity is provided, consistency is provided, partition tolerance is there, and second indexes are there, and no data definition language. Okay. So now see the structure of a particular document store. Okay, so here in the document may you have zero or more database. A database may contain more than one tables. No? So here all the objects are hierarchical objects. A document, like the document may have zero or more fields. These are the columns, column key values. Okay, actual key value for a particular column. So key indicates the column and value indicates the value of the column. So group of, everything is a collection. So collection of these key values, or this collection of these fields of RDBMS is your row. This row is nothing but document. And you have zero or more documents. Collection of documents is your database ka table, this blue color, database ka table. So your table table is a group of documents. And like this, multiple collections is your database. So the collections of documents is called as multiple tables of your database. Because your database may have a customer table, sales table, department table. So sales table is a collection of sales documents, or employee table is a collection of employee documents, and one document indicate one row, and one document has multiple fields. Okay, so you can visualize this as a hierarchical structure or hierarchical objects. Collection of fields means the collection of columns will give you a row or a document, and collection of documents will give you the table. Or a collection of document that is not called as a table, that is called as a collection of documents. And collection of collection of documents is called as a database. So database may have more than one collection of documents. Okay, so you have such a kind of hierarchical structure. Now just always keep in mind this concept of RDBMS, how it is mapped in MongoDB. A database of RDBMS is called as a database of Mongo, A table of RDBMS is called as a collection in MongoDB, collection of documents. A row is a collection, row is a document, and it is stored as a binary script object notation. A column is a field here, and indexing is possible. Here indexing is there, here also indexing on the values is possible. Here the joining is there, but here there is no join at RDBMS level, but the document can be embedded inside the document. Here for the foreign key kind of mechanism, here the references are used. So one document can be referred inside the another document through a reference or through a ID. Okay, and here we use the term as partition, but if the data is distributed, here we use the term as a shard. Okay, so I think I don't have to repeat this again. So this is the MongoDB ka structure. Okay, so a field, collection of fields is a document, collection of document is a table, and the database may contain multiple such collections. Okay, now suppose you have to show the relationship between the tables. So in case of MongoDB, such relationships can be modeled via embedded or such relationships can be modeled via embedded approach or a reference approach. And the relationships can be one-to-one, one-to-many, many-to-one, or many-to-many. Okay. Suppose you have two different tables or two different documents and you want to show the relationship between the documents. In case of RDBMS, you have the reference key and the primary key. But here, we don't have the key kind of concept. We have some other concept. And the such relationships can be established using one of the two approaches. Here it is in the bold color. Embedded approach, a document embedded within the another document, or it can be a referenced approach. Okay. And the relationships can be one-to-one, one-to-many, or many-to-one, or many-to-many. Okay. So we are, just see the example here. You have a user table. Okay. So this is your user table. For every document, an ID is generated. So we are not creating any ID. ID will be automatically generated, and it is a string. So this is an ID field automatically created. Its value is this generated by the system. And the user has user document has three key value pairs, that the name of the user and the value is Tom, the contact of the user and the contact number, date of birth of the user and his date of birth. So this particular user ka, all the details are there in the user table. And this is the corresponding ID to access this document. Okay. Now you have suppose address document to represent address of a user. So this address also have some ID, and the address document has a group of key values like the building and the name of the building, value of the building, pin code uska value, city uska value, Los Angeles, state and the state ka value. So all this is again a collection of key values. So address is a document, simple document, and we can embed this address inside the user because this is the address of the user. So user document, so this can be an embedded approach. So we can embed address document inside the user document. So we'll see that after embedding, whenever we do the insert operation, whenever we want to create the document, we can create it like db.users. Users is the name of the collection of users, all the users. Users is a collection of all the users, and in that we are inserting a user. Okay, so a new document is inserted, or a new row is inserted. In case of RDBMS, we say it as a row, and that user has this contact, date of birth, and name, and address is embedded. So in the users table, the address user document, address document is embedded. So this is an embedded approach. Means in these two curly brackets, see the syntax here. And in curly brackets, we write down. These are the two curly brackets where inside which the user table is there. This is a user table with three values. And then inside that address is an element. Means address is a key and this is the value. So there are two addresses for this user. We can have two addresses for the same user. There is flexibility. For one user, you may not have any address field. For this user, you are having two addresses. For another user, you may have three addresses. So all the flexibility is provided. And then suppose you want to retrieve this information, then you can say that to insert operation is done with the help of this insert query. To get particular value, you can apply a string such as db.users.find1. The name is equal to this and the address. So the first element will be retrieved. Okay. So the drawback is that the embedded document keeps on growing, then it will be a too much of size. And then it impacts read or write operation. If you go on increasing this embedded documents, then it may affect the speed for the retrieval of the query. So we can have a referenced approach also. So second approach to relate two different documents is a referenced approach. And this referenced approach for these two different addresses, the address IDs are created because they are the documents. So the IDs will be generated and you can add the reference. So this is the user table with three values, contact, date of birth and name, and then address IDs you are adding. So with this field, with this key and with this value, you can refer to another document. And now suppose you want to get the first address for this user, you can fire the query like this: db.users.find1. The name of the user is through this name. Whenever this name is there, the name is matched, then retrieve the first reference or first object ID for the address. Okay, so like this we can fire the queries also. Now see, everything is stored in the form of binary JSON format, that is binary script object notation format, and it can represent a simple data structure and associative array. Okay, this binary form is a form to represent simple data structures and associative array. Associative array is an array that is a modification of our normal array. Normal array elements are accessed using index A of 5 or A of 3. So by using indexes, we access the normal array elements. But in case of associative array, you have the corresponding key and the elements or values are accessed using the key, not by using an index. So this is a typical structure. Again, here the embedded approach is used. Here it is a movie table and the title of the movie, the type of this title is movie, then director name, and what are the actors who are the part of this movie. So different movies have different number of actors, so we get the flexibility. If we use the data RDBMS table, then our number of actors ke liye we have to assign, suppose there are 10 actors, so we can maximum store 10 actors. And if the movie is having only 5 actors, then other 5 fields will be having the value as null, and that is taking the space. Memory space will be allocated. Even if the value is null, the memory space will be allocated, and it is a wastage of. And the flexibility is not there, but here the flexibility is there. You can have different documents will have different number of actors embedded document inside the movie document. Okay, now we can compare even the queries of RDBMS and MongoDB query. In case of SQL, we can have a create table kind of query, create table movies. Instead of that, in MongoDB, we have the query as db.movies. Movies is the name of the collection. And insert will insert this particular document. That ID is equal to 10, name is equal to Titanic, and rating is equal to R. And the underscore ID will be created by the MongoDB database or data store, and it will be added. So this particular document will be identified or accessed by using that particular ID, object ID, created by default by the system. Okay. If whenever you want to say the query as select star from movies, the corresponding query in MongoDB is db.movies.find. That will give you all the documents. Suppose you want to update the movie rating as NR for the movie ID 101. Okay. So we can also have the update table, update query here we can say that db.movies.update, if the id is equal to, this id is equal to 101, and then you say dollar set rating is equal to nr, that will update the MongoDB ka table. And suppose you want to remove rows jiska rating is r. So here we can also have the similar kind of query, db.movies.remove, where the rating is equal to r, which will remove the corresponding rows from the table. Okay, so we can say that insert, search, update, remove is possible, while in case of key store, searching is not possible. You can only provide the key and get the value, but you cannot search for anything in case of key value. But here MongoDB mein you can search. This is another example to show the key value pairs. Here the key is a name and the value is this name of the person. Okay, so it is a string. Now here the address is a key and this is the value, okay, which is also a string. Now here the grandchildren is the key and the values are the names of the children and their age. So again it is a collection of key value pairs. The value of grandchildren is an array of values. Okay, it can be, it is a, no, it is a, it is not an array of value, it is a collection of key value pairs. Okay, so this is a key and the value is a collection of key value pairs. Phone mein it is an array of values. Phone is a key and the value is an array of values. So there are two phones for this particular person. Okay, so this is just to show you what kind of keys and values are there in case of document-based MongoDB. In the diagram also, you can see that everything is stored in the form of object. Key is a string mostly, and value can be anything. And the value can be a string or number or object or array or true or false or null or a list, anything. Okay, so you can see the reference here. This particular slide shows you how the references are used whenever the two tables are to be matched with each other. Like this particular supplier ka orders are there. So the supplier ka ID is 1 and the order, this is a particular order. So this table order is having a group of or collection of orders. Collection of orders, and it is a collection of suppliers. Now every supplier has a particular order placed. For every supplier, we place a particular order. So that order is identified with the help of order ID, and that same value is referenced, uska reference is maintained in this particular supplier table. Okay, so they are accessed via these references, but internally, as the architecture of MongoDB, nothing is done internally. Only whenever we create the table, that time we specify the reference of the other table, means other document. So one document has the reference to the another document. And suppose you are firing a query of joining, simple join, where you want to get the name of the supplier and the total cost. Then this name of the supplier is for ID is equal to 1, you get the, extract the name of the supplier, and then from order number travel and extract the another document. So in this collection you search the order ID 56 and from that document you extract 250 as a cost and display. Okay, so as such, at the database level, joins are not there, or they are not provided in the form of primary key or a secondary key or a foreign key, but a reference of another document is stored inside the outer document. Okay, so you have outer document and inner document kind of concept, and the reference of inner document is stored in the outer document. Means here in the supplier table, the reference of the order ID document is stored, and via references they are extracting the information. Okay, so here we can, these are the two document based data stores, Couchbase and MongoDB. MongoDB is invented by Tengen, that I told you. Couchbase is invented by Couchbase. In case of MongoDB, the data model is a object structured model stored in collections. and each object has a primary key called as object ID generated by the system. And in case of Couchbase, it is a document, is a list of JSON object. Here it is a list of it is a collection of binary script object notation objects, BSON objects. And for querying manipulations like insert, delete, update is possible. And here it is done by key and key range view via JavaScript or mappers. For MongoDB, you have APIs, and through APIs you can write the code to perform this queries. Okay, so this is the entire information about the MongoDB. Okay, so what so we have done with the introduction part of document store, MongoDB case study for the NoSQL databases. Okay, so we'll just have a recap here that RDBMS is not suitable because of lots of problems of RDBMS, because of joins and complex architecture of RDBMS. If it is the database, the size is getting increased. We can distribute, in case of RDBMS, we can distribute the table horizontally or vertically, but still it is it will not give you the results. It will take lots of time to extract the data and give you the information. So they are not at all suitable, and we go for NoSQL databases. NoSQL databases ka char types hai: key store, document store, graph store, and column store. And today we have seen document store. The example is MongoDB, and in case of document store, the searching is provided. Everything is in the form of key value, but in key value, it's a very simple operation. Just only key and corresponding value. Key and corresponding values are stored. Access anything via key, but searching is not possible in case of key value. Amazon DynamoDB. So here, in case of document store MongoDB, it is a full-fledged database kind of RDBMS kind of tables, and searching is possible. This RDBMS is a collection of documents. This MongoDB is a collection of documents, and a document indicates a row. One row has multiple fields. Every field is referred as a column of your RDBMS, and the field is in the form of key-value pair. Key is mostly a string, and value is can be anything. Value can be a string or list of value or array of values or another collection of keys and values, and everything is stored in the form of binary form, binary notation, object notation format. And your document is expressed in the form of a tree structure architecture, so searching is very easy. And whenever you want to show the relationship between two documents, then there are two approaches. Embedded approach. In case of embedded approach, one document can be embedded inside another document. And in case of reference documents, a reference of another document is stored in the outer document. And via references, the information is accessed. And you can fire the query like outer join, a normal join kind of queries. Okay, and you can perform all queries of inserting, updating, searching, deleting kind of operations in MongoDB. Okay, so I have told you in the beginning about the type of questions which are asked for this NoSQL database. They will ask you what is NoSQL database, explain the difference between RDBMS and NoSQL, and explain different architectural patterns of NoSQL. And they may give you the names of the architectural patterns, like explain key value and document store. So in that case, you need to explain these two. And then with the help of example, you have to explain the features, functionality of this data store. Okay. So I think we can stop for today, because the time is getting over, and the topic is also done. So next time we will start with the new NoSQL data store, that is column store, Edgebase. We will see Edgebase as a case study. Okay, so see you. See you on Thursday.